Subudi Raya Das.
Hare Krishna Gurudev, 我们都在，现在可以开始。
好。
Om Magyana Timurandasya Gananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're reading the Srimad Bhagavatam and we're on Canto 6, Chapter number 4, the Hamsa Guhya Prayers.
We're reading the Srimad Bhagavatam, Chapter 4.
Prajapati Daksha is offering prayers to the Supreme Lord.
Prajapati Daksha 向至尊主供奉祷文。
So he describes in his prayers. These prayers are actually taken from the scriptures. It's not his own prayers, but they're famous prayers which are which were passed down. For many thousands of millions of years.
这些祷文实际上不是由 Prajapati Daksha 自己所编纂的，这些祷文实际来自于韦达经，他只是从里面摘取过来的。
So he says there are two different sides. One party is the people who believe in God, and the other party they don't believe in God.
这个祷文继续描写到有两种派别，有一种是有一类人他们相信神，有一类人他们不相信神。
So people who believe in God, they understand God is a person and he has a body and he has, he wears clothes and, you know, he's a person.
那些相信神的人，他们认为神有一个躯体，而且他是一个人。
But the people who don't believe in God, you could call them, they're called, sometimes they follow what's called the Sankhya Shastra.
那些不相信神的那些人，他们有时候被称为 Sankhya Shastra.
And they believe in the existence of, they don't believe in the existence of God. They don't believe he has a form. They say that the absolute truth has no form.
他们不相信神的存在，以及不相信神有一个形体。他们认为绝对真理是没有形体的。
They say he has no hands, no legs, no name.
他们他认为神没有手，没有腿，没有脚。
So he has no hands and he has no legs, but the Vedic mantras say that whatever is offered to him, he can accept it.
他们认为神没有腿没有脚，但是韦达经又说，无论他我们向神供奉什么，他都可以接受。
So according to the Vedic mantras, there's the supreme He has hands and legs, but they're not hands and legs like our hands and legs.
通过伟达的这些曼陀罗，我们知道，至尊主没有腿没有脚，他有但是事实上他有腿有脚，而只是他的腿和脚，他的手腿脚跟我们不是一样的。
Our hands and legs are material, but the Lord's, he's not material.
我们的手和腿是物质的，但是主的手和腿它不是物质的。
He has a form which is eternal, full of bliss and knowledge, not a material form.
他拥有一个永恒知识和喜乐的形体，而不是一个物质的形体。
But those people who follow the Sankhya philosophy,They're called Gyanis. They say, no, he has no material form.
那些被称为Sankhya 的这些思辨者，这些哲学家，他们认为主是没有物质形体。
So we agree, he has no material form, but we say he has a spiritual form.
我们确实同意他这个观点，他确实没有一个物质的群体。形体，而且我们认为主他有一个灵性的形体。
And we can support that with evidence from the scriptures.
我们可以以经典的角度支持他这个观点。
So it appears there's like contradictions in the scriptures.
所以表面上看起来这是有一些矛盾的。
Because in some scriptures it talks about the Lord with no hands and legs.
因为有一些经典描述主就是没有手和腿的。
And other scriptures talk about him having hands and legs.
还有一些经典描述主是有腿有手的。
So we have to learn how to understand these contradictions.
因此我们应该理解这些矛盾之处是怎样一回事。
These people who are Sankhyites, the Gyanis, they are arguing about things from the material point of view.
这些Sankhya, 他们争论的是有关物质的这些观点，从物质的观点出发的。
And these Sankhyites,They're actually on the platform of Brahman, but they cannot understand the higher nature of Brahman.
这些 Sankhya 虽然他们是站在这种 Brahman 的层面，但是他们无法理解超出 Brahman 层面的。
That Brahman can also be person. There's a person who the Supreme Lord is.The Supreme Brahman, and he's a person.
Brahman 也可以是一个人，因为至尊的 Brahman， 至尊的 Brahman， 他是一位人。
But you can only know him by devotional service. So these Gyanis, they cannot understand him because they have no devotion.
因为只有通过奉献服务才能了解主，所以。然而这些 Gyani 们，这些思辨者们，他们没有奉献。
The Gyanis simply say they cannot have a form because they think any form, anybody has a form, it must be material.
这些思辨者，这些 Gyani 们，他们只是简单的否定物质的形体。他们认为一定那些有物质形体的一定是那些有形体的一定是物质的。
So we have to understand things by the power of devotion.
因此我们得通过奉献服务来了解这一切。
And then we can understand these contradictions.
这样我们才能够理解这些矛盾。
When there is contradiction, it indicates the inconceivable potency of the Lord.
当有矛盾的地方存在的时候，一定是主不可思议的能量的展示。
So these Gyanis, like the Sankhyites, they like to focus on the universal form of the Lord.
这些 Gyani 这些 Sankhya 他们喜欢专注于主的宇宙形体。
So we agree that's a good system for people in the beginning to understand that there's a person behind the universe.
我们也非常赞同这是一个很好的系统对于一个初学者来说去冥想主的这个宇宙形体。
Because in the beginning, people were very materialistic. They cannot understand God as a person.
因为在开始的时候，人们太物质主义化了，所以他们很难理解主是一个人。
So the universal form helps them to think about a person behind the universe.
因此，主的宇宙形体能够帮助人们去理解这个宇宙形体背后的这个人。
But that's only in the beginning. You don't want to keep that thinking all the way through. You have to give up that thinking, go on to higher levels.
但这种冥想体系只是对初学者，我们不应该只是永恒，一直不停地在这个层面上，我们应该放弃这个层面，往更高的这个层面上走。
We see in the Bhagavad Gita, when Arjuna first saw the universal form,He didn't like to see it forever. He just wanted to see it. Then he said, okay, that's enough. I don't want to see it anymore.
当我们在这个《薄伽梵歌》中看到阿尔朱纳看到宇宙形体之后，他说我再也不想看了，他只想看一会儿，然后就说我再不想看这个宇宙形体。
He wanted to see Krishna in his original two-armed form.
他想看到主 Krishna 原始的两臂的形象。
So devotees concentrate on the spiritual form of Krishna, which is full of eternity, knowledge, and bliss.
奉献者总是关注于主的灵性的原始的这个灵性的形体，那就是永恒知识和充满喜乐的这个形体。
So there are some people who are also devotees, but not so intelligent, and there are some people.They're not so intelligent, and they understand the Supreme just simply in a limited manner.
哈里克什纳,
did you hear me?
Can you speak again?
Yeah, the devotees understand Krishna as a person with a spiritual form, but there are other people who are not really devotees, but they're intelligent, but not too intelligent, they're a little intelligent, not too intelligent, and they understand Krishna in a different manner.
奉献者是接受主的超人的形体的，但是有一些智力不足的这些奉献者，他们有他们自己的这个方式去理解。
Yeah, their conclusion about the form of the absolute truth is different from the devotees.
他们对主至尊绝对真理的这个结论与奉献者的结论是不同的。
But devotees, we are convinced.That the form of the Absolute Truth is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
我们奉献者接受的是至尊人格守神的这个形体。
So Daksha continues his prayers, and he's talking about how the Supreme Personality of Godhead is very opulent.
Daksha 继续说到，继续描写到，至尊人格守神，他的富裕是非常无限的。
But at the same time, he has no material name or no material form or pastime.
与此同时呢，至尊主他没有任何物质的名字和物质的形体以及物质的逍遥时光。
And he is all pervading, and he is very merciful to the devotees.
他无处不在，对奉献者非常的仁慈。
And he, sometimes he will exhibit different forms and names for different pastimes.
有时他通过不同的逍遥时光展示拥而拥有着不同的名字。
So Daksha prays that the Supreme Personality of Godhead will be merciful to him.
Daksha 祈祷道，那位至尊人格守神，愿他能够对我满意。
So we have to understand what it means when we say having no name, that because this indicates that Krishna has no material name.
我们得理解，至尊人格守神他没有名字的这个意思是什么？意思意味着他没有物质的名字。
Just like we know, we heard already about Ajamil, how he chanted the name of his son, which was the name of the Lord, which was Narayan, and he got liberation by that.
我们听过这个阿加米勒的逍遥时光，就是他唱诵了 Narayana 来呼唤他的名字，然后得到的拯救。这个 Narayana 不是一个物质的名字。
So this Narayan, the name of Narayan is not an ordinary material name, it's spiritual.
这个 Narayana 的名字不是一个普通的物质的名字，而是一个灵性的名字。
So any name of the Supreme Lord doesn't belong to the material world.
主的任何一个名字并不属于这个物质世界。
And the Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is not material sound. Spiritual sound vibration.
Hare Krishna Maha Mantra 也不是物质的声音，它是灵性的音阵。
And Krishna's appearance and activities are not material, all spiritual.
Krishna 的显现以及他的活动也不是物质的，全部都是灵性的。
So different times, Krishna will appear in the material world.For the pleasure of his devotees, and also to teach the non-devotees.
主在不同的时间在这个世界显展示他的逍遥时光，是为了奉献者的快乐，同时也是为了教导那些非奉献者。
So all people who are not very intelligent, they cannot understand how the Lord appears.And how he has these different names and forms and pastimes.
那些缺乏智力的人，他们无法理解主的显现，也无法理解主的这些逍遥时光形体和名字。
They think that this must be material. They cannot understand that they're not material, they're spiritual.
他们认为这些都是物质的，他们无法理解这实际上不是物质的，而是灵性的。
So they say the Supreme has no name and he has no form.
因此他们会说，至尊没有名字，没有形体。
So non-devotees, they say God has no name, and devotees who know his name, we know the name's not material.
这些非奉献者说主没有名字。但是奉献者知道主有名字，但是不是物质的。
They know his name. They know that Krishna has no material name, form, birth. Everything about the Lord is not material. It's all transcendental.
奉献者知道主的名字、形体，还有所有的这一切都不是物质的。都是超然。
Krishna's body is not under the modes of nature.
Krishna 的形体并不处在物质自然三形态之内。
But still, Krishna comes into this material world and maintains himself on the transcendental platform.
但是主 Krishna 仍化身显现在这个物质世界，维持他自己的超然的层面。
And he comes in this world to show mercy to his devotees.
他来到这个世界是为了对他的奉献者展示仁慈。
So other people, they spend their time arguing about whether or not the Lord has a form. Does the absolute truth have a form? But the devotees, we don't waste our time arguing with them.
有一些人就喜欢争论这个至尊的绝对真理到底有没有形体，但是奉献者 不会花浪费时间与他们去争论这一切。
Because by the grace of Krishna, a devotee will be able to see the form of the Lord, and then when he sees the form of the Lord, he'll become ecstatic.
通过主的仁慈，奉献者就能够在一定的时候见到主本人。当奉献者见到主本人的时候，他就会变得狂喜。
And then, of course, people also say, "Oh, if there's the absolute truth, he doesn't have any activities. He doesn't do anything."
有一些人也会觉得，至尊主他无所事事，他不需要做任何事情。
And even there are scriptures which say that the absolute truth has nothing to do.
即便是有些经典也会说主他没有需要他做的事情。
But actually, everything has to be done by with his permission. Without his permission, nothing can be done.
但是事实上，所有的一切都必须在他的允许下才能够运作。没有他的允许，没有什么可以做得了。
So the foolish people, less intelligent people, they cannot see how Krishna is doing everything.
那些愚蠢的、没有智慧的人，他们无法理解至尊主所做的一切事情。
And everything is working under his direction.
一切都在主的指导下运作着。
But these foolish people, they cannot see how Krishna is doing everything and how he's working. So they think there's no God.
这些没有智慧的人，他们无法看见，无法理解主的活动，所以他们认为主是无所事事的。
Or they say, if there is a God, he doesn't have anything to do and he has no name.
或者他们认为如作为主的话，他没有什么需要做的，而且他也不应该有名字。
But actually, Krishna has names according to his different activities.
但是事实上，主他是有他的名字的，根据他不同的活动，还有不同的名字。
Just like Krishna means all attractive, because Krishna is so attractive to everyone.
就像 Krishna 是具有全面吸引力的，因为 Krishna 本人对每一个人来说都是非常具有吸引力的。
And when he was a small boy, he picked up the Govardhan Hill, and then he also killed many demons when he was a child.
当他还是一个孩童的时候，他举起了戈尔瓦丹山，而且还杀死了很多恶魔。
So sometimes he's called Giridhari, person who picks up the hill.
因此他有时候被称为 Giridhari, 那位举起戈尔瓦丹山的人。
And sometimes he's called Madhusudana, one who killed the demon Madhu.
他还被称为 Madhusudana, 那位杀死 Madhu 恶魔的人。
Or Aganishudana, that he killed the demon Aga.
他还被称为 Aganishudana, 他杀了这个 Aga。
And because he's the son of Nanda Maharaj, when he appeared in this world, it was like Nanda Maharaj was like his father, so he's called Nanda Tanuja. But these non-devotees, people who are not devotees, they cannot understand these names of Krishna.
但是那些非奉献者，他们无法理解 Krishna 的这些名字。
So they say God has no name, he has no material name.
他们认为主没有名字，没有物质的名字。
But we know he has spiritual activities, and therefore he has also spiritual names.
但是我们知道他有灵性的活动，因此他也有这些灵性的名字。
So these foolish people, they're thinking Krishna has no form, but we know he has an eternal form of bliss and knowledge.
那些愚蠢的人，他们认为主没有形体，但是我们知道主有这个永恒、充满知识和极乐的形体。
And he came to take part in the battle of Kurukshetra, and he came also to protect devotees like the Pandavas and to kill the demons.
他们主来到这个库鲁之野战场上，上演保护奉献者、消磨、消灭恶魔的逍遥时光。
So this was all the mercy of Krishna.
这些都是Krishna的仁慈。
But people think, oh no, the Absolute Truth has no form, he has no work to do.
人们认为绝对真理他没有形体，无所事事。
But when Krishna comes, he shows us that he has work to do. He did many things.
但是当主Krishna前来的时候, 他向我们展示他有很多的事情, 而且他做了很多的事情。
And he did things which nobody else could do.
而且他做的这些事情没有其他人能够完成。
He married 16,108 wives.
他娶了16,108位妻子。
It's impossible for any ordinary human being.
这对一个普通的人类来说是极不可能的事情。
So when he comes in this world, he shows people how great he is.
当他来到这个世界的时候，他向人们展示了他是多么的伟大。
And he shows people also how merciful he is.
而且他还向人们展示了他是那么的仁慈。
Although his name is Krishna, he will act in so many wonderful ways.
虽然他原始的名字是Krishna, 但他仍展示了无穷无尽的活动。
And therefore he will have many, many different names.
因此他也有非常非常多的不同的名字。
Then Daksha continues, he says, just like the air carries different characteristics of the elements, the air will carry different elements like the aroma of flowers or colors coming from the dust that can all be in the air.
这个导文继续说到，就像空气携带着物质元素的各种物质元素，比如说空气中有花朵的芬芳，还有空气中会携带着尘土混合在一起。
And so in this way, Krishna can appear through different systems. It can appear through different methods of worship according to the devotee's desire.
因此。 主 Krishna 也会以不同的崇拜的方式显现，根据这个奉献者的这个愿望。And
he may even appear sometimes as a demigod, not in his original form, but he appears like a demigod.
因此，他有时候甚至显现为半身人。这个虽然不是他原始的形体，但是他有时候显现为半身人。So
Daksha says, "What's the use of all these other forms?"
Daksha 说：“这些其他的形体又有什么用呢？”
And he says, "May the Supreme Lord fulfill my desires."
愿这位至尊人格守神能满足我的愿望。
And so the impersonalists, they often think of demigods like the forms of God.
这些非人格主义者。 通常会把半世人的形体作为是主的形体。Yeah,
they worship many gods, and they think ultimately they're all one.
他们崇拜着很多的神，他们说终极来说，所有的都是一。And
there's a type of impersonalism where they worship five demigods.
有一种非人格主义者，他们崇拜五位半世人。But
they don't actually believe in any one form of God.
但是实际上，他们不相信任何这五位中的一位是神。But
just for their worship, they imagine some form to be God.
他们只是为了崇拜而想象出 一些作为神的形体。
Yeah, they imagine a form of Vishnu or a form of Shiva.
因此他们想，他们虚构出 Vishnu 的形体， Shiva 的形体。
And then the form of Ganesh and the sun god and Durga.
而且还有 Ganesh, 太阳神以及 Durga 女神的形象。
So these are the five different demigods they like to worship, and they think of them as all being forms of God.
这五位半神人是他们崇拜的形象，他们认为这五位半神人，他们虚构出这五位半神人的形象作为神的形象来崇拜。
But Daksha, he didn't want to worship these forms. He wanted to worship the supreme form of Lord Krishna.
Daksha, 他并不想崇拜一个虚构的形象，他想崇拜主 Krishna 的形象。
So there's a difference between the Supreme Personality of Godhead and an ordinary living being.
至尊人格守神和普通的生物之间是有区别的。
The Supreme Lord, he knows everything, but the living being, we hardly know anything.
至尊主他能够知道一切，但是个体生物他很难以了解一切。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, "I know everything, but nobody knows me."
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说："我知道一切，但是没有人能知道我。"
So this is the difference between Krishna and the living entity.
这就是至尊主和普通生物的区别。
And Queen Kunti says the same thing. She says.You're inside everything, you're outside everything, but nobody can see you.
昆体王后也这么说，您既在内也在外，但是没有人能够看到您。
So we cannot understand Krishna by speculation or by imagination.
我们无法通过想象和思辨来理解至尊主。
Krishna reveals himself to the devotee.
Krishna 向奉献者揭示他自己。
We need to become devotees. You can understand Krishna only by devotion, not by speculation.
我们只有通过成为奉献者，做奉献服务，能够理解 Krishna, 而不是通过思辨去理解 Krishna.
People may speculate about the absolute truth.What is his form? Where is he existing? But they can never understand the truth.
人们或许能够，或许会思辨，或许会推敲出主的形体，主在什么地方住着，但是他无法了解绝对真理。
We can only know Krishna by devotion. He only reveals himself to the devotee.
我们只能通过奉爱服务了解 Krishna.Krishna 也只向奉献者揭示他自己。
So less intelligent people want to imagine or make up a form of Krishna by their imagination.
有一些人他们创造出虚构出主的这个形象，通过他们自己的想象。
But a devotee just simply wants to worship the Supreme Lord.
但是奉献者他想崇拜真正的至尊主。
Somebody may think of Krishna as personal, some other people may think of him impersonal, and some others may imagine him.
有一些人认为您是，就是有一些认为主是人格的，有一些人认为是主是非人格的，还有一些人认为主是虚构的。
But Daksha prays, he said, I just want to see you as you are.
但是 Daksha 的祷文说我只祈祷我能够目睹那位原始的您，真正原本的那位您。
So this is important for the impersonalist to understand.
Sorry.
It's important for the impersonalist to understand this point.
这对于一个非人格主义者来说，要理解这一点是非常重要的。
The impersonalist.They're thinking that there's no difference between the living entity and God. They're thinking that there's only one Supreme Truth and that the Supreme Truth is everyone.
他们认为只有一个绝对真理，而绝对真理是所有的人。
So this is foolish, this is stupid to think like that.
所以这是很愚蠢的。
But people who think like that, they're thinking they're very advanced, but actually they're very stupid.
人们认为自己有这样想法的人，有这样想法的这些人，他们认为自己是非常进步的，但是实际上这种想法是很愚蠢的。
So there are three classes of men. There are the lowest of men, there are the people in the middle, and there is the best of men, the highest men.
有三类人，最低的人，中间的这一层人，还有最优秀的人。
So the lowest men, they think there's no difference between God and the living entity.
最低的呢，这一层人，他们认为主和所有的生物是没有区别的。
The only difference is that living entity is in different designations. They designate themselves in different ways. But the absolute truth doesn't have any designation.
他们认为一旦designation.
Designation, yeah, we're thinking, you know, I'm a manager, or I'm the boss, or I'm the
cook. Okay. 他们认为，就是说，他们认为就是个体生物是有不同的这个称谓，但是主是没有 designation， 没有个体的不同的称谓。
They think.When the material world is all finished, then the living entities will just mix with the Supreme Lord.
而且他们还认为，当这个一切都结束之后，物质躯体毁灭之后，它能够和至尊者融为一体。
And they give the example, just like a pot with air in it, and the sky.The air outside of the pot. So, you know, there's a pot, and within the pot there's some air. But outside the pot there's also air.
就像他们还举了一个这样的例子，在一个罐子里面是有空气的，罐子外面也是有空气的。
So when the pot breaks, the air in the pot mixes with all the air outside the pot.
因此当罐子破碎了之后罐子里面的空气就会和罐子外面的空气融为一体。
And so the impersonalists say the living being in the same way he becomes one with the supreme.
因此非人格主义者认为当生物离开躯体之后生物就会和至尊者融为一体。
So this is how these people argue like this.
这就是他们所争论的这些观点。
So the Acharyas say this kind of argument is put forward by the lowest class of men.
但是先辈的这些导师们说，这样的观点只是有那些最低等的人才会提出这样的观点。
Which is stupid to compare living entities to a pot or to air.
他们竟然把这个个体生物和这个罐子这个空气融为一体，相提并论。
It's not a good example.
这并不是一个好的类比。
So people who argue like that, they're stupid, they're very low class.
人们持有这样观点的人是比较低的人。
So you've got other class of people who they say the actual form of the Supreme.They say that you cannot actually know what is the actual form of the Supreme.
另一类人，他们说，我们事实上不能了解至尊者的真实形体是怎么样的。
But they agree that there is a Supreme who controls the activities of everyone.
但是他们赞同有那么一位至尊者，他控制着一切。
So these people they're medium, they're in the middle, they're intermediate, they're not good, they're not the best, they're not the worst.
所以这样的一类人，他们既不是最好的，也不是最差的，是中间的。
But the best are those who understand that the Supreme Lord has a form of eternal bliss and knowledge.
最优秀的那一类人，他们认为有至尊主，而且他有永恒知识和喜乐的形体。
And the form of the Lord is completely different from that of the living entities.
而且他们还认为这位主完全与其他的个体生物是不同的，决然不同的。
So people who think like this, they're the best people because they know that the Supreme Personality of Godhead can reveal himself to his devotees.
这一类人他们是非常优秀的，因为他们知道这个至尊主他能够向他的奉献者揭示他自己。
But he reveals himself differently to different kinds of people.
但是他向不同的人不同的揭示着自己。
People who are like in the modes, lower modes, passion and ignorance, then the Lord will reveal himself in different ways.
那些受自然物质自然形态不同影响的人，比如说激情和愚昧形态的人，至尊主会以不同程度的方式揭示他自己。
So there's 33 million demigods just to convince people that there's a supreme God over everyone.
有3300万半世人使灵魂确信存在。
And that all these demigods are there to remind us that there's a supreme power.
所有的这些半世人都让我们就是说能够提醒着我们有那么一个至尊的力量的存在。
And we should agree to worship him.
我们应该同意去崇拜这些人中的一位。
To get people to agree to worship one of these demigods Daksha says that we get people to worship the demigods and then they're able to understand that there's a supreme power over the demigods and they can worship Krishna as the supreme God.
Daksha 在这里说就是说崇拜半世人能够了解有那么一个至尊的力量，同时也能够让人理解到有至尊的人格守神的存在。
Yeah, because Krishna himself is the source of all the demigods.
因为 Krishna 是所有半世人的源泉。
Krishna is the supreme truth. Everything rests on him.
Krishna 是至尊的真理，所有的一切都来自于他。
So Krishna is above everyone, even Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva and all the other demigods.
Krishna 高于所有的半世人，即便是主 Brahma, Shiva 还有其他所有的半世人。
So if somebody accepts these teachings, then he's considered a first-class philosopher.
所以有这样一个观点的人，他被认为是一流的哲学家。
And such a that person, he knows that Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead over all the demigods.
他知道 Krishna 是超越所有半世人之上的至尊人格守神。
All right, so this is, that's the end of Daksha's prayers. So now Sukadeva Goswami is speaking.
刚刚我们讲的就是 Daksha 的这个祷文的结束的部分, 现在Sukadeva Goswami 要说话。
So he describes how the Supreme Personality of Godhead was very pleased by the prayers of Daksha.
他描述到
So the Supreme Lord appeared at that holy place where Daksha was, at Agamarshana. He appeared to Daksha.
所以至尊人格守神在这个叫 Agamarsha 的圣地, 在那里向Daksha显现的。
And the Lord's lotus, when he appeared, he was on the shoulders of Garuda, and he had eight long, very beautiful arms.
主在Garuda的肩膀上，而且呢，他有八臂，八臂非就是八只非常长的、非常美丽的手臂。And
in each hand he was holding different things. One hand he had a disc, another hand a conch shell.
他每一只手都有不同的武器，有神碟，有海螺。
And in another hand, he had a sword, and a shield, and an arrow, and a bow.
还有刀，就是刀、盾、剑、弓。
And he had a rope and a club.
绳索和绳锤。
So in each hand he had a different weapon, and everything was effulgent.
每一只手都有不同的武器，而且所有的武器都非常光辉灿烂。
And his clothes were all brilliant yellow.
他的衣服总是亮黄色的。
And his body was a deep blue color.
他的肤色是深蓝色的。
And he was very, his eyes and face, he was very cheerful, very happy.
他的眼睛和面庞非常的喜乐。
And round his neck he had a long garland of flowers all the way down to his feet.
长长的花环从他的脖子一直垂到地面上。
And round his neck he was wearing the Kastuba jewel on his chest.
在他的胸膛上挂着这个Kastubha宝石。
And also the mark of Srivatsa was there on his chest.
在他的胸膛上还有Srivatsa的这个标记。
And on his head, there was a beautiful helmet.
在他的头顶还有非常美丽的头盔。
And his earrings, he has his special earrings he wears, which are like sharks.
他的耳朵上挂着这个鳄鱼形状的耳环。
So everything was very beautiful.
所有这一切显得都非常的美丽。
And he had a golden belt on his waist and bracelets on his arms.
他腰上有一个金色的腰带，在臂上还有臂环。
And rings were on his fingers and ankle bells on his feet.
手上有戒指，脚上有脚铃。
And so he had all different ornaments on his body. He was very attractive to all the living entities all over the three worlds.
对于三界的所有的生物体，他非常具有吸引力，吸引了三个世界所有的生物体。
And so he's known as Purushottama, the best personality.
他以Purushottama著称。
And when he came, he didn't come alone, but he was with his great devotees like Narada and Nanda and all the principal demigods.
他和他的奉献者一起前来的，比如说有 Narada, Nanda, 还有所有的这些众。
And Indra, the king of heaven, he came, And he brought all the residents of the other planets of the demigods.
还有Indra 带了所有其他这些主要星球的主要的办事人都来了。
Right, the people from the Siddhaloka and Gandharvaloka, Charanaloka.
比如说西达的 Loka, Gandharloka 和 Charanaloka.
So they were all on, they were on both sides of the Lord, and they were all offering prayers to the Lord all the time.
他们都站在主的两侧，而且也不停地向主献着祷文，一直在向主献着祷文。
So when Prajapati Daksha, when he saw the Lord coming with all these people, he was a bit afraid.
当 Daksha 看到主和所有的这些奉献者一起来的时候，他 还有一些害怕。
But then he became pleased to see the Lord coming to him, and he fell on the ground offering his obeisances.
但是呢，他又非常的快乐地迎接着主的到来，而且呢，立刻拜倒在地，向主献出顶拜。
Just like rivers are filled with water which flows from the mountain.
就像河流从山中流出水。
So Daksha's senses were all filled with happiness.
Daksha 的所有的感官都充盈着快乐。
And Daksha couldn't say anything, but simply, he was simply laying on the ground flat.
Daksha 几乎不能说任何的话，他只是笔直地倒在地上。
So when we actually realize, when we actually see Krishna, when we see the Lord, we'll feel so much happiness, so much pleasure.
当我们能够亲眼地见到主 Krishna, 见到至尊主的时候，我们会充满着极乐。
Just like when Dhruva Maharaj saw the Lord, when the Lord came to him after he'd been doing austerities for 6 months, then Dhruva Maharaj said, "Now I don't want anything. I'm fully satisfied."
当 Dhruva Maharaj 在做了六个月的苦行之后，主来见到他。的时候，朱瓦玛拉说：“我亲爱的主，我现在什么都不想要，我已经完全的满足了。”
So when Prajapati saw the Prajapati Daksha saw the Supreme Lord, in his presence, he simply fell flat. He was unable to say anything. He didn't want to ask for anything either. He just kept quiet.
当 Prajapati Daksha 看到至尊主显现的时候，他也说不出任何的话，他就笔直地倒在地上。
But the Supreme Lord knows everyone's heart, and although Daksha didn't say anything, the Lord knows what was in Daksha's heart.
虽然 Daksha 一句话都没有说，但是主知道每一个人的内心想着什么。
And he knew Daksha was desiring.That his desire was to increase the population.
他知道 Daksha 的愿望是为了增加人口。
So the Supreme Lord begins to speak to him.
所以至尊主准备开始对他说话了。
So maybe we'll stop here, then we can go on from there next time.
Okay. 我们先讲到这儿，下次再接着。
Are there any questions?
Yes. Here is a question from Charu Chitra Manaji. Hare Krishna, my humble basis to dear Guru Maharaj. My question is, what is the difference between Dhyana Yoga and Sankhya Yoga? Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Well,Dhyana Yoga.
Sorry, Gurudev, 我把这个翻译成中文。 这个第一个问题是来自于查尔西传巴姐，他说顶拜咕噜，我想知道 Sankhya Yoga 和这个 Gyana Yoga 的区别是什么。Hare Krishna。
Gyana Yoga will be coming from, that's the knowledge from the Vedanta. Generally they study the Vedanta, the teachings of the Vedanta.
Gyana, 他们专注的是学习维丹塔的这个知识。
And we say just like the Mayavadi sannyasis, they're generally called, they're on the path of Gyana, cultivating knowledge.
就像我们看到这些 Mayavadi sannyasi, 他们专注于培养知识。
And Sankhya, the Sankhya teachings,This is from the atheist Kapila. There's an atheist Kapila, and they analyze the elements of the material nature.
Sankhya 是来自于无神论者 Kapila, 他的一套哲学，他专注于的是分析这些物质元素。
So you can see both processes are based on a lot of speculation.
所以我们可以看到这两个系统，它们都是有很多的思辨推敲在里面的。
We want to understand the absolute truth. We have to hear. But these people, they don't hear. They just simply rely on their own mind, their own intelligence, and they analyze everything.
我们培养知识，我们是依靠聆听，但是这些人他们是通过他们自己的思辨，他们的心意和他们自己的智力去推敲这些知识。
So the Gyanis, they're analyzing, they're studying Vedanta Sutra to understand everything, and the Sankhyites, they're studying the material world, they're looking at the elements of the material world and trying to understand everything.
这些 Gyani, 他们是通过学习知识来了解这一切。这些 Sankhya 的这些人，他们是通过分析这个物质世界的不同元素来了解这一切。
And they take a lot of guidance fromThe atheist, there's an atheist Kapila, and he taught that life comes from matter. He taught that matter is the origin of life. It comes from chemical combination.
他们的哲学是在这个无神论的卡皮拉这个人的指导下进行研究的。他们认为生命是来自于物质。
So Sankhya is a system of analyzing the elements of the material world.
Sankhya, 他们是分析这个物质世界的不同的元素。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisance.We see that in Kali Yoga, moral degradation goes on very quickly, and only 5,000 years have passed since the beginning of the Kali Yoga. What will happen next? After all, Kali Yoga will be for very long time.这个中文是 Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受我的卑微的顶拜。我们在卡利年代看到道德就是下降的非常的快，仅仅过了5000年过去了，道德下降的很快。我们想知道接下来会发生什么。
So、
在卡因为卡利年代会有很长的时间，只是发生了5000年这个就下降，接下来会发生什么 ？Hare Krishna。
So you read Srimad Bhagavatam 12th canto and you get descriptions of what's going to happen at the end of the, as we go through Kali Yuga.
我们只需要阅读圣典博加瓦坦的第十二篇，就知道在卡利年代接下来会发生什么。
It's described how people will become greatly burdened by taxation. The governments will tax people very badly, and it will be very difficult for people to live.
接下来这个人们的这个负担很重，人们给这个政府的政府给人们的这个税收也很重，人们很难以生活下去，维系自己。
And people will have to go and live in the forest.
人们必须不得不到森林里面去维系，去到森林里面。
And as Kali Yuga goes on, it will become very difficult for people to survive. There will be practically no food.
随着卡利年代继续进行，人们很难以生存，甚至都没有食物了。
People will even have to start living underground.
甚至人们得到地下里面去生活。
Then at the end of Kali Yuga, there will only be some demons left, and Lord Kalki will come, and he will kill all the demons, and then Satya Yuga will begin.
在卡利年代的末尾，这个地球上只剩下恶魔了。然后呢 ，Kalki 就来了，主 Kalki 就来了。他把所有的恶魔杀掉了之后，黄金年代又开始。
Okay.
Next question.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from Tom.Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj, 顶拜所有的奉献者，请问如何区别心智思辨和对经典的研习讨论？ Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru Maharaj, I want to ask how to distinguish between the mental speculation and the sastra, studying the sastra together.
Yes, for mental speculation, you're just simply using your own mind to understand everything.
心智思辨的这个意思就是说，你只是通过你的心意去了解这个经典所说的。
But philosophical speculation should be guided by Shastra.
我刚刚说错了哈，心智思辨就是说你只是通过心意去了解一切，而经典的研习讨论是在经典的指导下。
Yeah. So we are encouraged to understand everything on the basis of Shastric conclusions.
我们所有的一切是基于经典的结论。
We don't just simply try to understand by our own mind, thinking.
我们对所有的一切的理解不能只是基于我们自己的心意的思考。
So we have to use the shastras and see the conclusions of the shastras.
因此我们要看到经典的这个结论是什么。
Prabhupada said, just like in the Bhagavad Gita,Krishna says, I am the taste in water.
就像圣帕帕德说，主 Krishna 在博迦梵根说，我是水的滋味。
So Prabhupada said, guided by Shastra, we should try to understand, how is Krishna the taste in water?
因此我们得借助着这个去理解 Krishna 如何就是水的滋味。
So it's important you have to read the books, we have to know what's in the books, and we have to use that knowledge to understand everything properly.
我们得运用这个书，而且要了解书中所讲的一切的知识，然后要实际的去运用书中所讲的这一切的知识。
But these jnanis and mental speculators, they just understand things by their own mind.
但是这些 jnani, 他们只是通过他们自己的心意去推敲知识。
Just like we were talking here. They think anybody who has a form must be material form. They cannot understand that there could be a spiritual form.
就像我们今天所讨所在这个圣典摩迦梵坛中所了解的这个吉亚尼他们所认为的观点，他们认为任何有形体的这个，他们一定是物质的形体，但是他们不知道还有离性的形体的存在。
Okay, yeah.
Okay, yeah. Next question from Hanivamsa Prabhu, Dimbai Guru. Daksha, 为什么这么有灵性的知识，也做了很多取悦主的服务，而为什么冒犯了主希瓦和纳尔达？这间接地提醒了我们什么？Obeisances to Guru, Daksha have so many spiritual knowledges and do a lot of service to the Lord. Why he offends the Lord Shiva and Narada? What this pastime remind us?
Well, reminds us to be very careful in dealing with the Lord.
这个提醒我们要非常小心地和主相处。
Now, Daksha, in the previous incarnate, in his previous life, he was offensive, but in this life, he's doing much better.
Daksha 是在潜意识做了很多的冒犯，在这一世他做得非常的好。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Radha Priya Manaji. 顶拜故事莲花组，感谢翻译和主持的甜美服务。请问我们为了服务 Krishna 和奉献者的时候，需要制定什么计划吗？还是顺其自然的等待 Krishna 的安排就好？这样能更轻松的服务。Obeisances to Guru's lotus feet, and I want to ask for serving the Krishna and the devotee better. Shall we make some plan, or we should wait for the Krishna's arrangement, then it will be much better and relaxed.
Well, if you can make some plan, it's good. You have to be organized. You can't just simply sit back and depend on Krishna to do everything.
我们不能在背后就等着 Krishna 来安排一切。如果我们能够做一些计划，让一切有组织，这比较好一点。
Yeah, so they have to have some organization, just like, you know, Prabhupada set up the society. He organized things.
我们需要有一些计划，就像圣帕帕德，就是管理了这一切。
So some organization is encouraged there.
所以一些计划和安排是被鼓励的。
Prabhupada said we have to be very organized. We're fighting Maya.
圣帕帕德说我们得非常有组织，因为我们在和玛雅做斗争。
So we have to be very organized.
因此我们应该非常有计划。
You see other societies, they're very organized. Why we cannot be organized?
我们看其他的一些社会或社团，他们也是非常有组织的。为什么我们不应该很有计划？很有
？You look around the world, you see everywhere people are organized. Why we're not organized?
我们看到整个世界都是很有计划、很有组织的。为什么我们不应该这样呢
？So organization is required.
组织计划是非常需要的。
Okay.
Okay. No more question.
Okay.
Okay.
So today is the disappearance day of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and also Gadadhar Pandit.
今天是 Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 和 Gadadhar Pandit 的隐居日。
So Gadadhar Pandit, of course, he's one of the members of the Panchatattva.
Gadadhar Pandit 是 Panchatattva 中的一员。
Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktivinoda. So Gadadhar is the manifestation of the internal potency, which means Srimati Radharani. He's like a partial incarnation of Srimati Radharani in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya.
Gadadhar 在这个Krishna 的这个逍遥时光，实际上是主 Krishna 的内在能量 Srimati Radharani， 他在主 Chaitanya 的这个逍遥时光中显现为 Gadadhar。
And Gadadhar, he spent as a child, he grew up with Lord Chaitanya. His home was very near to Lord Chaitanya's home, and they grew up together and they went to school together.
Gadadhar 在小的时候，他是和主 Chaitanya 居住在很近，他们一起去上了学。
And from childhood, he was always deeply attached to Lord Chaitanya.
他从小的时候就对主 Chaitanya 非常的依附。
So, he was always trying to associate with Lord Chaitanya. But Lord Chaitanya, in the beginning of his life, he did his pastimes of as being a scholar, and he was studying and became a great logician and a big teacher.
他和主 Chaitanya 小的时候就在一起。主 Chaitanya在小的时候很快就成为一个大的学者，然后成为一个逻辑学家，就是在知识方面非常的博学。
And people were a bit afraid to meet Lord Chaitanya because whenever he would meet them, he would argue with them and he would challenge them to a debate and he would defeat them.
人们在当时是有一些害怕见到主 Chaitanya， 因为主 Chaitanya 一见到他们就会和他们辩论，然后并把他们给打败。
But then it happened that Lord Chaitanya went to Gaya and he took initiation from Ishwarapuri. And then when he came back, he was transformed and he was a devotee.
但是当主 Chaitanya 去到 Gaya 之后，从 Ishwarapuri 那里接受启迪之后，他就转变了，他转变成了一个奉献者。
And so then they began the kirtans every night at the home of Advaita Acharya.
从那个时候起，他就开始在 Advaita Acharya 的家里每天做 kirtan， 唱诵。
And so Gadadhar was there for all these pastimes.
Gadadhar 每一天都参与这一个逍遥时光。
So it happened one day a great pandit, one day Makunda, who was a friend of all the devotees, Makunda, there was this one devotee called Makunda, and he told Gadadhar that there's a great devotee coming, and his name is Pundarik, you should go to see him.
有一个奉献者叫姆昆达跟 Gadadhar 说，有一个叫 Pundarik 的这个大人物来了，你得去见一见他。
So Gadadhar, he went to see this Pundarik, and when he saw this Pundarik, he was a bit disappointed because he saw that this Pundarik he looks like he's very materialistic.
但是当 Gadadhar 见到这个 Pundarik 的时候，他有一些失望。他觉得他看着这个 Pundarik， 感觉他有一些物质化的这种感觉。
So, he saw this Pundarik, he's got, you know, he's very opulent dressed and he's got many things to eat in front of him and he's got all different servants fanning him.
因为这个碰到瑞克，嘎达尔见到他的时候，他穿的也很豪华，吃的也很豪华，仆人还在给他扇着扇子。
He's sitting on a big seat, and he's dressed in nice clothes, and he's got a lot of jewelry on.
他坐在一个很大的座位上，有很多的仆人在服务着他。
So, Gadarhar thought, well, I don't think he could be a good devotee. He looks very materialistic.
Gadarhar 就想，我不认为他是一个很好的奉献者，他看上去有一些物质主义者的这种感觉。
So Gadarhar, because Gadarhar is a brahmachari and he was very renounced his whole life. So he
因为嘎达尔是一位是一个 brahmachari 真守身，他这一生都非常的气绝和真守。
And when he just couldn't accept that this man is really a great devotee, he just looked so materialistic.
他无法接受这样一个人，他是一个奉献者，因为他自己就是一个。他感觉这个人有点物质主义者。
So then the one devotee was there, Mukunda, and Mukunda began to sing a verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam about the mercy of Krishna.
当时 Mukunda 也在场， Mukunda 就吟诵了圣典波迦瓦坛一个荣耀主 Krishna 的诗节。
And the verse goes, Aho bhakayam stanakala kutam jagam sayapayanadapya sadvi. Like this, the verse is from the third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. It's a verse spoken by Uddhava. He's speaking about who could be more merciful than Lord Krishna.
这个诗节是来自于圣典波迦瓦坛的第三篇，由 Uddhava 讲述的，谁可以比 Krishna 更仁慈呢？
Because Krishna accepted Putana as his mother. Although she came to poison him, Krishna accepted her and took her back to Godhead.
因为主 Krishna 甚至接受了 Putana 作为他的母亲，即便 Putana 过来是为了来毒死他的，但是 Krishna 接受了他作为他的母亲的这个地位。
So when Mukunda sang this song, then Pundariki heard this song and his love for Krishna awakened and he became ecstatic and he fell off his seat and he rolled on the ground and he cried and cried and he rolled on the ground and he was shedding tears and the whole floor became flooded with water from his tears.
当 Pundariki 听到这个诗节了之后，他立刻唤醒出内心对主 Krishna 的这个爱的狂喜，他从座位上掉了下来，然后在地上满地的打滚，身体颤抖，泪流不止。
So then Gadarhar was thinking that, wow, he said he thought this man is really a great devotee.
这个 Gadarhar 就在这个时候发现，哇，这个人确实是一个很伟大的奉献者。
So Gadarhar thought, he said, I think I must have made an offense by thinking that he was a materialist.
所以 Gadarhar 这个时候心里就想，我肯定对这个伟大的奉献者做出了冒犯，因为我内心竟然认为他是一个物质主义者。
So it happened that Gadarhar decided he should take initiation from this man.And he got permission from Lord Chaitanya, and he took initiation.
So Gadarhar 于是想从这个 Pundariki 那里接受启迪，然后他也寻求了主 Chaitanya 的允许，主 Chaitanya 允许他从 Pundariki 那里接受启迪。
So we said Gadarhar in Krishna Lila, he's Radharani.、And、so this man who gave him initiation is Pundarik.He is the father of Radharani in Krishna Lila. He is Maharaj Vrishabhanu.
我们说 Gadarhar 在 Krishna 的逍遥时光中是 Srimati Radharani, 而这一个给予 Gadarhar Pandita 启迪的这一个奉献者 Pundarika, 他在 Krishna 的逍遥时光中是 Radharani 的父亲 Srimati Radharani 的父亲 Vrishabhanu Maharaj.
So then later on, Lord Chaitanya took sannyas, and when he took sannyas, Gadarhar cannot be separate from Lord Chaitanya, so he followed him to Jagannath Puri.
当主柴坦尼亚后来接受三亚西启迪的时候，噶达尔无法忍受这种分离，他也想去Jagannath Puri。
And Gadarhar was staying in Jagannath Puri with Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya found a deity of Radha and Krishna. He gave it to Gadarhar to worship.
噶达尔潘迪的在 Jagannath Puri 和主柴坦尼亚在一起，然后主柴坦尼亚找到了一对 Radha Krishna 的神像，并给予了噶达尔潘迪。
And this is the deity Tota Gopinath, which is still worshipped today there in Puri.
这一对神像叫 Tota Gopinath, 这个神像到今天也在 Puri 被崇拜着。
So, Gadarhar, when he was staying in Puri, he took a vow that's called Kshetra Sannyas. He vowed that he would never leave Jagannath Puri.
噶达尔潘迪特在江格纳的普瑞的时候，他发下了一个誓言，叫 Chaitra Sannyasi, 就是说他永远不离开江格纳的普瑞。
But then Lord Chaitanya left Puri, so when Lord Chaitanya left Jagannath Puri, then Gadarhar wanted to follow him. He also wanted to go.
因此当主柴坦尼亚要离开江格纳的普瑞的时候，噶达尔也忍受不了这个分离，他也想离开。也想跟着主柴坦尼亚一起。
So Lord Chaitanya doesn't like people to be unsteady in their devotional service. He didn't appreciate Gadarhar. He didn't want Gadarhar to give up his service.
主柴坦尼亚并不希望奉献者的奉献服务那么的不稳定，他不希望噶达尔放弃他的服务。
Lord Chaitanya wouldn't allow Gadarhar to go with him. Gadarhar was very upset.
所以嘎达达主柴坦尼亚不允许嘎达达跟他一起，嘎达尔也非常的悲伤。
But when Lord Chaitanya came back to Jagannath Puri, Lord Chaitanya was always going to visit Gadarhar, and together they would read Srimad Bhagavatam.
当主柴坦尼亚再返回加格纳的普瑞的时候，他总是会去拜访嘎达尔，然后他们一起学习圣典波迦瓦坛。
Lord Chaitanya was very fond to hear about the pastimes of Dhruva Maharaj and Prahlad Maharaj.
主公查坦尼亚非常喜欢朱瓦马哈拉吉和普拉达马哈拉吉的逍遥时光。
So it said when Lord Chaitanya left the world, one of the places where he disappeared was they say he entered into the deity of Tota Gopinath.
当主柴坦尼亚离开这个物质世界的时候，他进入的是这个 Tota Gopinath 的形体之中。
If you go to see the deity, you can see the mark on the leg of the deity. They say this is where Lord Chaitanya entered.
当你如果去见，如果去觐见这个神像 Tota Gopinath 的时候，现在他们还有个标志，就是在腿那里有个标志。他说这个标志就是。主柴坦尼亚进入这个神像的地方。
So Gadarhar was worshipping the deity, but in his old age it was difficult for him to reach up to put the crown on and to put the ornaments on the deity because the deity is quite big.
当 Gadarhar 非常年迈的时候，对于他来说非常难以继续再崇拜这一个神像，因为这个神像非常的大。
So the deity sat down. It's an unusual deity. Usually deity standing, but this deity sitting down.
通常这个神像是站着的，但是这个神像是个非常不寻常的神像，所以这个神像那个时候坐了下来。
So this is Krishna's mercy on Gadarhar Pandit that the deity sat down so he could worship it easier.
所以这是神像，这是主 Krishna 对这个神像对 Gadarhar Pandit 的一个特别的仁慈，让他能够 很容易的去崇拜他。
So Gadadhar stayed in Jagannath Puri and he has many disciples and many disciples and they still continue there and the worship of the deity is still going on.
Gadadhar Pandita 仍然有很多的这门徒然后在那里继续在崇拜的这个神像。
When we go to Jagannath Puri, we often take prasad there at the temple of Tota Gopina.
当我们去到加格纳的普瑞的时候，我们也经常去到这个神像 Gopinath 那里去荣耀 Prasad。
We can go. We're allowed to go into that temple to see the deity.
我们是被允许能够进入到这个庙里面去觐见这对神像。
Okay, so today is also disappearance day of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
今天也是 Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 的这个隐居日。
And he is our spiritual forefather. We're very much indebted to him for all the wonderful gifts he has given us.
他是我们灵性的这个曾祖父，给了我们非常多宝贵的礼物。
He discovered the birthplace of Lord Chaitanya.
他发现了主柴坦尼亚的出生地。
And he wrote about.The Parikrama, Navadvip Parikrama.
他还撰写了 Navadvip Parikrama 绕拜这一本书。
Described all the holy places around Navadvip Dham.
描写了 Navadvip 所有的这些圣地。
And he also wrote many wonderful songs, which we're very fond of singing.
而且还撰写了很多 Vaishnava 的这些歌曲。
Like the Gaura Arti song, which we sing every evening.
比如说 Gaura Arti 的这个祷文，我们每天晚上唱的。
Or the Jai Radha Madhava, which we sing when we give class.
比如说在我们讲课之前唱诵的 Jai Radha Madhava 这首歌也是他写的。
He wrote also the songs we sing in the morning, Vibhavari Shesha and Udila Aruna.
而且他还撰写了这个早上唱的这首 Vibhara Shesha 的这首歌
And Udila Aruna
Udina Aruna 这首歌
All beautiful songs which we sing every morning about the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya and the names of Krishna
这首就是关于主 Chaitanya 的逍遥时光的这首歌以及所有关于主 Krishna 名字的这些歌
So Bhaktivinoda Thakur understood that difficult for us to just think of Krishna. So he had everybody sing songs about Krishna and about Lord Chaitanya.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 认为我们是很难以一直想着 Krishna 的，所以他写了这些歌曲，让我们想着 Krishna 以及主 Chaitanya.
So Bhaktivinoda Thakur went, he also wrote about the Namhata.The preaching of the holy name and how the marketplace of the holy name could be taken to every town and village.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 还写了这个 Namahata, 就是圣名的市场，在每一个地方我们都可以。
And Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur preached in all the villages around Bengal and Orissa, and he had the same program we have.Everywhere he would go, they would do kirtan, he would give a lecture, then they would distribute prasadam.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 在孟加拉地区的每一个乡村都传播圣名，这也是我们所正在做的。我们去到每一个地方，我们都传播圣名，然后我们也派发 prasadam.
So, we're really very, very deeply indebted to Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur for his work in trying to establish the Krishna consciousness movement.
We're very grateful to Bhaktivinoda Thakur for establishing Krishna consciousness.
In the same year, Srila Prabhupada was born, 1896, Bhaktivinoda Thakur sent books to America and to Canada about the life of Lord Chaitanya.
在同一年1896年圣帕帕德出生的那一年圣巴克提诺塔库尔写了 主柴坦尼亚的这一个的这一本书，然后寄到了加拿大。
So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur understood that in the future, the holy name is going to be preached all over the world.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 知道，他知道在未来 ，Krishna 的圣名会传遍整个世界。
So, today we're remembering Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and we're praying to him to please be merciful on us, help us to also contribute to this Lord Chaitanya's mission.
今天我们也向 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 祈祷，希望他能够对我们仁慈，让我们能够对主 Chaitanya 的使命这个运动做出一点点贡献。
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to live over at Swarup Ganj, just across Sijalangi from the Mayapur temple. His residence is there, and his samadhi is there also now.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 的居所在贾朗底河对面的那个地方，我们现在也经常会去那个地方。
So sometimes people like Jagannath Das Babaji would come there,and Gorkhishor Das Babaji, and sometimes Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati would also be there. So all the four Acharyas could all be there at the same time.
有些时候Jagannath Das Babaji, Gorkhishor Das Babaji, 以及 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Thakur 也会在那里。所以我们先前的这些灵性导师有时候全部都会在那个地方一起聚集在那里。
Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur took initiation from Bipin Bihari Goswami, but he didn't include Bipin Bihari Goswami in the parampara when Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati began the temple. They didn't put Bipin Bihari's picture in the parampara. They just put Gorkish Jagannath Das Babaji.
事实上 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 是从 Bipin Bihari 这个那里接受启迪的，但是当 Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Thakur 建庙的时候，他没有把 Bipin Bihari 的照片放在上面，他认为他不是来自于师徒传系的，于是就放了 Jagannath Das Babaji。
So it indicates Bhaktivinoda Thakur was also giving importance to Shiksha.That Shiksha is also important. It's not only Diksha, but Shiksha is also important. You've got to get instruction.
这里要强述的这个要点是强调的这个要点是 Shiksha 有时候比这个启迪更重要，就是训示比这个启迪要更重要。
So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur gave great importance that you have to get shiksha. You have to, it's not just take initiation and go away. You have to get instruction from the spiritual teacher.
这里很重点的强调，我们应该很从灵性导师那里接受训示，而不是接受完启迪之后就马上就离开了。接受训示比这个启迪要更重要。
So it's very important that we continue these programs, having classes and asking questions, because it's a great opportunity for all of us to get knowledge and to get instructions.
而且我们现在这个学习能够给予我们每一个人机会，能够得到训示，接受训示。
Okay, so on this auspicious day of the disappearance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Gadadhar Pandit. We're also reminding you that tomorrow is the day of Gundicha Marjanam, the day for cleaning the temple. So you're keeping Jagannath there. You have to, even if you're not keeping Jagannath, you have Lord Krishna there, you should clean the temple very nicely, because tomorrow is the day when Lord Chaitanya would go to the Gundicha temple and clean the temple.
今天是一个特别吉祥的日子，就是 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 和 Gadadhar Pandit 的这个隐居日。明天也是一个很重要的日子，就是清扫拱地场庙。主 Chaitanya 会在这一天 去打扫拱地禅庙。如果你们家里有这个加格纳巴德和苏巴扎这个神像的话，你们要好好的打扫你们庙。如果你们的神像是拉达克什纳的话，也应该好好的打扫你们的庙宇。
嗯。And cleaning the temple means also cleaning the heart.
清洁庙宇意味着清洁我们的内心。
We have to get rid of all the dirty things from the heart.
我们应该摆掉我们内心所有的这些污垢。
So Lord Chaitanya personally took part in the cleaning of the Gundicha temple.
所以主柴坦尼亚亲自去打扫了拱地禅庙宇。
And then on Monday,Then there is Rati Yatra.
之后就是 Rati Yatra.
Monday, 星期一。
星期一，星期一。
Rati Yatra in Jagannath Puri. That's at Jagannath Puri, Rati Yatra. So we can also watch on the online. I think you can be able to see some of the highlights of the Rath Yatra on the computer network. Okay, are there any other questions? Any questions or comments, anybody, about Bhaktivinod or Rath Yatra or anything? Okay, if there are no questions, then we'll finish here.
好的，谢谢古鲁，谢谢各位奉献者的参与，谢谢翻译，翻译大概已经下线了。那么今天的联谊就到这里，古鲁感恩您，顶拜您的莲花。
Okay, 我们感谢苏布里来，普布给我们整台的翻译，我们感谢奉献者聆听，我们祝福你，好好念诵，注意身体，多保重。Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.